mercenary companies are owned by a warmonger. The nature of this role varies greatly, so it could be one person or a big corporate board. Their ethics, too, can vary from noble bright to nihilistically violent. Regardless of their size or ethics, mercenary companies are contractors all the way down. There are a few key roles that interact with the war market. Colonels operate behind the scenes and coordinate logistics permits and larger strategy. They rely on tactical managers as well. Tact managers don't just plot engagements, they also plot engagement in the social media sense. And both of them interface with the warmongers who, as I said, pay them and run the companies. Company colonels, therefore, rely on company captains for personnel and squad management. A captain is a recruiter and manager first and foremost, and a combat leader second. That's what lieutenants are for. They get missions from colonels and organize personnel for deployment. Captains are the managers that troops most often interact with. This is important because you can't get away with being a terrible manager in a mercenary outfit. Thanks to the war market, troops can easily find better reviewed and high payer outfits, and captains are always looking to assemble better and better combat units. There are also recruiters, both freelance and dedicated, who work for companies to hire new troops. They look to the dregs of society. They look to job boards, gamer leaderboards, and social media to find fighters and support troops alike. So, as you can see, a PMC is more of a roster of contractors than it is any kind of independent army. Sometimes.